Hello, mind healers, and welcome to my channel. It's Sharon here, and I'm happy to talk to you today about a subject that may or may not influence you in life, and that is that big word that everybody hates to hear, anger. What makes you become angry, and what makes you think that your blood is boiling and boiling when you get angry? And do you get that angry? And where does that come from? There's many, many things in our life that we learn as we go along, and that can be also from the people that we're around, the people that we were brought up with, the friends that we have, and also the mentors that we've had during our young to adult life. So it's important for us to realize where our anger comes from about ourselves and how we can best deal with anger, because there's a lot of people right now with what's going on that are really angry. They're angry about losing their jobs, they're angry about being financially burdened, they're angry at the government, they're angry at the coordinators of this virus, they're angry at the fact that they're being forced to do things that they don't want to do, and that can also create a lot of stress. So stress is really correlated with anger, because we need to let it out. It builds up and builds up. Have you ever been in a situation where you're calm and everything's fine, and you know, you think, oh, I'm coping with everything, and then it's slowly building until one day you go kapow and you lose your anger? Or you may be somebody who's got a bit of a short fuse and you do lose your anger quite easily, which can all be about triggers. Have you ever heard about triggers? We've all got triggers within us that relate to how we respond or react to situations. So we need to ask ourselves, are we responding or are we reacting? Because reacting is very different to responding. I'll tell you the difference. So here's an example. So let's just say you came home from work and you had a really hard day, and then one of your kids just start saying, mom, dad, and they're just like want and gone, until finally you get to the point where you're just like, you lose the plot, and you're like, that's it, I've had enough. And you either storm off or do whatever you do when you're angry. Swear, obviously. Now what I want you to think of is, what really triggered that for you when you're in that state? It's the build-up. There's several ways that we can cope with these sort of things. One way of coping with it is just saying, hey guys, I just had a really, really hard day. I just need 10 minutes. Can you give me 10 minutes just to gather myself? I'm gonna go into the room. I'm gonna get changed. I'm gonna, have a few deep breaths. Just take a moment out, have some time out. And I'm pretty sure that most of your family, friends, or whoever's with you or around you at that time is really going to appreciate, first of all, that you're being honest with them and telling your truth, and also respecting the fact that in order for you to be a better person around them, that you're giving them that space. So that's important for us to definitely realize that when people, that stress and anger are very, very closely associated in most instances. So that's one way that you can deal with not only being stressed about your day or, the pressures of life, is by responding, not reacting. Because when we're reacting, then usually the mirror effect is that the other person reacts, and then there's a big fight that's going on, which is not good for anybody, because people say hurtful things when they're in an angry state. Have you ever been in a state where you've said something and you're like, my goodness, I can't believe I said that. That's so mean. That's so hurtful. How could I say that? And later on, you're apologizing for saying those awful things to somebody that you maybe love, admire, and care about. So this is about not only respecting others, but respecting yourself from the viewpoint of the scenario I just shared with you. That We're respecting ourselves by asking for the time, and the other people are respecting you for giving you that time. So that's a really wonderful solution. If you're in a situation where you've just walked in the door and things are a bit manic, and I know it's hard for mums too, because sometimes they want to offload their kids. I've been there myself, had a bad day with the kids, and you need that 10 minutes, you go, okay, I'll give you 10 minutes and then I'll have mine. So let's be fair about what we're doing and how we're doing it, because anger is a very resentful emotion, and we can be very, very sorry for the things that we say and do. The other thing to think about is that when you become angry, there's several things you can do also. One of them is to take a nice deep breath. First of all, take a deep breath and stop. Just stop. Don't use that vocal, okay? Because, whew, like I said, sometimes you can regret it. So let's just stop, think. Think really about, what am I getting angry at? Why am I becoming angry? And is it really that important for me to be that angry about it? Okay, so that's what we call triggers. So there's triggers. So like I said, it can be stress from work. It can be that somebody said something and it just triggers you and then you're off. So we need to learn what our triggers are so that we can then take that deep breath and say calmly to the other person, I really don't know, like what you said there and why you said it. I understand why you said it, but my version is this. So maybe you can talk to them in that way. Because the thing is that when we're stressed or when things are out of control, you know, like a lot of people feel like their lives are out of control right now. They don't have control over where they can go, what they can do. And that can be very frustrating. And frustrating is another word that's associated with stress and anger as well. So it makes you feel helpless. You feel helpless. And you feel that it's really upsetting you. And being upset is what can really make you and trigger you to be angry. The other thing you can do sometimes when you are feeling angry about a situation is think about the solution. And as I say, sometimes that deep breath, stop and think about it and think, okay, what's the solution to this? Or can I go and ask someone for some help? You know, because the more we try to understand each other and we understand ourselves, the better we become at not working and moving into that negative emotion. So is anger something for you that makes you feel powerful? Does it, you know, is it your ego that's coming out of the closet every single time when you get angry? Are you becoming defensive about things when you're angry, because they're touching a soft spot within your heart and within your life? So sometimes we need to look deeper into what is going on, why we're becoming angry and why we're becoming upset, so that we can work on a solution and we can get the answers that we need and the help that we need. I really hope that this helps you, because anger is something out there in society, you know, in domestic, private, public situations that are happening, you know, in pubs and clubs, etc. And we are such beautiful spirited human beings, really, and we all can get on. There's enough of everything for all of us. We need to be grateful for everything that we have, the people we have in our lives, the things we have in our lives, and that's what I mean by material things, but also be grateful for the minimalistic things and the things that we can do to help others, and be grateful for the beautiful planet that we have. Because in the end, anger really doesn't get us anywhere. We waste lots of energy on anger. When we're calm, we end up with more anger. And you will find that if you can work through that anger and have a conversation with somebody, even if you're upset, how you're going to feel at the end of that will be fulfilled. You'll feel confident. You'll feel better about yourself. You'll love yourself, because we must love ourselves first before we can love others. Well, thank you so much for listening today. I really hope you've enjoyed my video. Please do click the like button and subscribe, and click the bell button if you would like to get my notifications every time I put out a video. At the moment, I'm putting out 3 to 4 per week, and I'm really enjoying helping you. And these are just guidelines, just guides, just ideas and things that I've learned myself during my life that I would like to share with you. So may the light in me be the light in you. See you later, Mind Healers, and have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will talk to you again soon. Bye.